Here you have a steel ball falling at constant speed in oil. Interesting. Why constant speed? Oh, because got drag force in oil. Which graph shows the variation of two energies, GPE and the KE of this ball as it is slowly falling down? Pew, 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 in a liquid of oil. Ah, yeah, I should have chosen some other color. Never mind lah. So when we think of KE, we know very nicely that it's not going to change. If you're at a constant speed, then your kinetic energy is also constant. No? So EK is constant also. So when we look at the graph, let's see which one we can cancel out. A and B, EK is a straight line throughout the entire journey. Steady, steady. Okay, very good. C and D. Wow, why is it getting faster and faster? Nani, getting faster? Something is wrong here. On this side, also getting faster? No, does not work that way. No. Steady, steady. Because there's drag force, there's frictional forces in the oil itself. So C and D are out. Then between A and B, we need to decide. For GPE, is it going to be a curve or is it going to be a straight line? How do we know? One way to think of it is EP is MGH, right? So we can conclude that EP... wait a second. You see the axis is time. Time. We need to somehow link time into here. So we know the height is changing with respect to time. As you suddenly move down, move down, move down, a certain displacement. So actually, you can use the equation S equals to UT plus half AT squared. But you see, there is no acceleration. Velocity is constant. So it's just S, or rather height, equals to the velocity times time. So you can say, the displacement or the height changes with respect to time, lah, something like that. So therefore, you can say EP is proportional to height, and height is proportional to time. Linearly, therefore, we put together the whole chain. Therefore, potential energy is going to be proportional to time, and that is a linear relationship. Got any square, t square, square root? No, right? So, straight line. So, there'll be no curves. This is not correct. And B is our best choice. Okay? Whenever you see graph and you're not sure of the trend, you could make smart guesses, or you could try to think of equations to confirm the trend of the graph. Alright, so that's all for this video. I will see you in the next one.